Okay, it's actually time for us to finally start trying to turn our ABO gene into an ABO protein. And the first thing we're going to do is go from DNA to RNA, which is the first step of the central dogma, via the process of transcription. So if you look here, we have our double-stranded DNA, our double helix, and it's wound up. We're going to follow along the gene right here. And as you can see, as it moves across on the bottom region here, we have the chemistry, the chemical structure, and on the top region, we have the letters that actually make up the same DNA structure. Obviously, the chemistry on the bottom is something that's a little more difficult to read, and that's why we have the letters, which are right there on the top model. To help us better see what's going on here in the double helix, we're actually going to unwind it the way a cell normally would. When a cell finds something interesting in DNA that it wants to read more or know more about, it often unwinds the DNA a bit so it has better access. Now the cell is going to use proteins to detect where transcription should begin, and we're going to learn more about how that happens in the next lesson. But for now, all you should know is that this sequence region is called a promoter. A region of DNA that's read or detected by proteins that signals the start of transcription. Once the proteins are bound to the DNA, it not only begins to unwind, but it begins to separate into single strands to give greater access and initiate transcription. Our double helix has been unwound and separated into single strands here. And for transcription to occur, it will rely on a very basic property of DNA. So I want you to see if you can tell me, what property of DNA do you think is most essential to make an RNA copy? Do you think it's that DNA is able to associate with histones, that it can have a helical structure, the fact that it base pairs, or the fact that it's inherited from your parents? Go ahead and pick which answer you think is best.